96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
The views and opinions of the hosts and guests are their own and do not necessarily reflect the position of the management and staff of Guardian Network.
Record with Zhivargo Laing is brought to you by Burger King, RF Bank and Trust, and Royal Star Assurance.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am. Happy, happy new year to all of you. Happy new year to every single one of you. You and me, we made it. And we're still going strong. Z Live and my audience. Some said you wouldn't make it, you know. Some people thought you wouldn't make it. And here you are, January 2nd, 2024, still here. Whatever age you are, still here. In whatever stage you are, still here. In whatever mindset you are still here. All the great challenges you walk through in 2024, you're still here, whether they were physical or financial or family or friends or whatever it was, still here. And you're the only one I dream of. All right? But you stay here. God bless you. God bless you this 2024, as he did in 2023, and even more abundantly in 2024 than he did in 2023. And may you find ways to exceed and to pass all the things that you were able to accomplish positively in 2023, in 2024. And may you find ways to overcome all the things that caused you problems, posed challenges to you, gave you headaches. May you find a way. I can't pray for you to have no challenges, because you're going to have challenges. You better believe that. We are going to have challenges. But what we need is the strength, the ability to be able to overcome them. And you can do so. You walk through 2022, 2023, and now you're here in 2024. And I wish you a happy, happy, happy new year. Ah, boy. Looking forward to all the things we are going to do this year together here on the show. But otherwise, in your private and personal affairs, I look forward to the kinds of achievements and accomplishments we can have, the things we will be able to accomplish in the country. In the country. Look forward to that as well. All right? 2024 has some significant things that are going to take place, you know. Some significant things in 2024 across the world and in the country. For example, in November of this year, the U.S., the United States of America, will hold, I believe, consequential presidential elections. It will be quite interesting to see how that election turns out. Chances are, it seems, Donald Trump, former president of the United States of America, will be the Republican candidate in that election, and that Joe Biden, the president of the United States of America, will be the Democratic candidate. And so those two will go at it again. It was very close the last time. It was contentious afterwards. It was riotous afterwards. And here we go again. So that's something to look forward to. That'll be November 5th of this year. November 5th. Of this year. Also this year, the Olympic Games, the Olympic Games will take place in Paris, France, as well as the Paralympic Games, and that'll be between July 26th and August 11, 2024, in case you plan to travel to go and attend the Olympic Games. That'll take place this year. The U.S. is going to have elections this year. Guess who else is going to have elections this year? I mean, there are a number of countries that will have elections this year, but I'm talking about ones that might weigh on your head. Mexico is actually having elections this year. And guess what's true about the Mexican elections this year? The Mexican elections will be held on June 2nd, 2024 of this year. And for the first time, two women will contest for the presidency of Mexico. Yes, sir. Claudia Sheinbaum and Xochitl Galvez will contest for the presidency of Mexico. It'll be interesting to see how a combination of a U.S. president, Biden or Trump, works with a combination Mexican president, Sheinbaum or Galvez. So that's something to look forward to in 2024. I mean, lots of things happening in 2024. I'm just noting some things that piqued my attention. This is a leap year, of course. So this is a leap year. You all remember, 30 days has September, April, June, and November. All the rest have 31, except February, that has 28 days during the course of a leap year. And this is a leap year this year. This is also a lunar year, actually. So there'll be a full eclipse, lunar eclipse this year. And this year, I'm expecting, as so many are, huge leaps forward in artificial intelligence. I mean, there you are, something. Artificial intelligence is no joke. That thing is no joke. That thing is revolutionizing how people work, what people can accomplish, what people can do. They got people, you know, this thing, chatbox. They got people asking chatbox to do the kinds of things that, man, you had to have had some particular set of fantastic skills to do one time ago, and chatbox and do it for you in a short while. You can pay some money, but it, artificial intelligence proposes to make some huge leap forward this year. If you are someone whose job is, as they say, mechanized, you know, routine, AI could do your job for you. And some of you think that's only mean people who do physical labor. That's not true. There are people who do work that AI could do for you. If you answer the phone, and you answer the phone asking and answering simple questions for people like, where do I find, who do I go to, where do I go to? AI could do that for them. Say Trump. So the jury's still out on him, I hope. Well, the jury is always out until something's actually done. But the fact of the matter is, he leads in the Republican polls by plenty, plenty, plenty. And these efforts to kind of keep him off the ballot in some of these states are mostly in Democratic areas, and that's not going to prevail. So unless something dramatic happens, and we've seen many dramatic things in Trump's political career that didn't sideline him, unless something really, really extraordinary happens, he is going to be the Republican candidate for president. And so it's going to be interesting. Of course, this year we also have another budget to be presented by the government of the Bahamas, which I think will be interesting. This is year 2024. Elections in the Bahamas is going to be year 2026. So think about it. Here's how it works. So this budget year, it will start July 1, and it will end June 25th. Okay? So the next budget, which we typically say is an election budget when it is happening in the year that election is due. So this budget, if the government is going to do big things, they can't wait for the July 1, 2025 budget alone to get those things done. Because that will give them only 12 months or so in the electoral term to do it. And so this budget and the next one are likely to be statement making ones for the government. Let's put it like that. That's my thought on that, right? And so looking out for that budget is going to be interesting. I think looking to see what happens in Grand Bahama, this 2024 is also going to be something to see. Remember all the talk the government had about the Port Authority, and that kind of stuff? Well, you got this year, and you got next year, and then you have election. So we'll see what happens in this year. 2024 is going to be interesting in many, many ways, I think. Interesting. Lots of things happening in the world. You know, the global economy is not like, it's not excelling, right? It's trying to recover, but it's not excelling. And political instability abounds everywhere, not just between nations, but actually within nations, there's political this ease at best, unrest at worst, right? And so it's going to be interesting to see what happens. Says, great show as usual. Happy New Year. If Biden could run for election at 145, it's never too late in life to accomplish your goals. And Mr. Biden is not 145 years old. He is not. So stop trying to put that on him. He's an old man. But, you know, age, I don't do the age thing. If you are competent, if you are capable, then it doesn't matter how old you are. However, if an organization has an age limit and says you have to retire at 60, you have to retire at 65, then at 60, 65, you got to go. But other than that, I mean, I'm not, I don't get caught up in that because, you know, that ageism, you know, there is a, if you are going to succession plan, you have to take account of age only because what age tends to mean for a person's robustness, vitality, a person's abilities, and what have you. But most more often than not, we look to age for much guidance and experience and wisdom and so forth and so forth. I don't get caught up in that now. If the United States voters decide that Mr. Biden or Mr. Trump is too old, then that's on them. That's their choice. God bless them. You're listening to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. When we come back, I got a question for you. We'll be back after this break.
I'm not afraid to take a stand, take a stand. Everybody, come take my hand, we'll walk this road together, through the storm, whatever weather, cold or warm, let me know that you, holler if you feel like you make it down the same road.
Babe, you moshed the car?
I moshed the car. The lady run into me, moshed the car.
I hope she had insurance.
If she had insurance, she hop out, pull out her phone, pull out the Royal Star Assurance app, and bang, she was on a video call with an RSA rep, sending pictures of her damage, my damage, filing a claim on the spot.
For real? Our insurance have that kind of app?
You gotta go to RSA for that.
Download the RSA app today, or visit rsabahamas.com to submit your claim online. Live chat available weekdays 9 to 5.
Struggling to repay your loan? Let us help you get back on track with payment terms that suits your financial situation and improve your credit score and credit report with the Bahamas Credit Bureau. Inquire about our restructured loans today. Call us at 356-7764.
Secure your financial future with RF Bank and Trust. Explore the RF Secured Balance Fund. Designed for long-term financial security, this diversified fund offers both growth potential and a steady income source. Plan for the long term with a recommended minimum investment of 5 years. With over 2 decades of experience, RF Bank and Trust is your expert in preserving and growing wealth. We're your local private bank, connecting you with the best local and international investment opportunities. Don't miss the chance to secure your financial future with RF Bank and Trust.
Love the show? Want to give your support? Become a sponsor today. Call 302-2300 for our rates and packages. That's 302-2300. Become a sponsor on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
I'm not afraid to take a stand, take a stand. Everybody, come take my hand. Storm, whatever weather, cold or warm, let me know that you're not alone.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. So glad you could join us here today on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM on this beautiful Tuesday afternoon, January 2nd of 2024. If you want to give us a call, the numbers are 323-6232. That's 323-6232 or 325-4316, 325-4316, or 325-4259, 325-4259, or from the Family Islands, 242-300-5720. You can text us on 422-4796, or you can WhatsApp me on 439-3043 on Cable Bahamas, channel 969. That's the way my mother listens to the show. Or you can catch us on BTC Flow Channel 612. That's BTC Flow Channel 612. I was totally abandoned on New Year's Day. All my family was all over the place. And nobody was with me. Listen. No one. Everybody was all over the place doing their stuff, man. And I got together with some good friends of mine, and we had mutton sauce, and we had turkey wing sauce, and we had peach sauce, and yes, I did all that. Did some Johnny cake and so forth, and so we enjoyed that. We enjoyed that yesterday. How did you spend your New Year's Day? I didn't do any junkanoo at all. I see the Saxons has won two straight. I ain't hear nobody calling, crying, or whining, or complaining. Saxon took it two straight. But I had a good first New Year's Day. I ended New Year's the way I wanted to end it. I started it the way I wanted it to start. And so that for me was a good start. I do want to give you a heads up. From January 23rd to January 26th, I don't want anybody sitting here, they have been surprised. From that's Monday, January 23rd to Thursday, January 26th, we're going to have our financial week. So you can get, yourself together, because we're gonna give you a personal financial checkup. We can help you, we're going to walk you through that personal financial checkup. Then we're going to give you some lessons and guidance on budgeting, on banking and borrowing. And then on day three, we're going to look at some savings and investment opportunities for you. And then on day four, we're going to look at insurance and risk management. In January 23rd to 26th, Finance Week, Personal Finance Week here on ZLive. We're going to have some experts to come and give us some real guidance on those things. And listen to me, folks. It can save you a fairly great deal of headache, stress, strain, having your finances organized in a way that you require. And it is possible. No matter what your circumstances are, it is possible to improve your financial circumstances, okay, your situation. And if you are able to listen in, you'll be able to get some guidance on that. So I have a question for you. Yes, question. What could make the difference? Big difference between your being healthy and unhealthy this year, in your being foolish or wise and unwise this year, between your having a relationship that having relationships that work or relationships that do not work. What could make the difference this year between whether your government actually works for you or your government works against you? Whether your government actually performs or your government doesn't perform, what would make the difference in those situations? What could make the difference between your eternal fate and your today? What could make the difference? What thing is there that could make such a huge difference in your circumstances? That could make the difference between your being broke or your being broker. You're being broke. And you're having some money. You're having some money. You're having more money. You're having more money. You're having much more money. What could make the difference there? What could make the difference between your having a sense of peace and well-being and your being stressed out and really mentally unstable? What could make the difference between any one of all or all of those things in your life in 2024? What could make that difference? Anybody? Text me, call me, tell me what could make the difference. I'm not going to tell you yet. What could make that difference? What could make the difference between whether you have a household that enjoys order and civility and a household that does not? What could make the difference between whether you are taken advantage of or you are able to work with other people in ways that work for both you and them? What could make that difference? This text says, my mindset and outlook on life are on about 80% of your list. Okay. So somebody says your mindset or on your outlook. Okay, I accept that those things can make a difference, but that's not the answer I'm looking for, but they can make a difference. No question about that. This text says my orientation, mind, mood, and emotions. I accept that those things could make a difference, but some of those are results. They are not the actual thing that make the difference, right? The thing that I'm talking about will make the difference to your mindset, will make the difference to your mood, will make the difference to your emotions, make the difference to your physical health. So this thing is powerful, very powerful, very potent. I'm not talking about a little bit of difference. I'm talking about a huge and massive difference it can make in our lives, in three area of your life. It can make a difference. Big difference. Public life, private life, social life, work life, play life, can make a huge difference to your life. What is that thing? Huge difference. You interact with people on a regular basis, and this thing is playing a role in that interaction every single minute. You interact with your family members, it's making a difference. You interact with yourself, it's making a difference. This thing is huge. This thing is powerful. This text says positivity. Now, positivity is helpful, but it's not the thing. In fact, positivity depends on this thing. So, no, that's not the thing. What is it that could make a huge difference? You see this country of ours, what could make the difference between us having an economy that's growing at 2%, 1%, and us having an economy growing at 3%, 4%, 5%? What could make the difference between us having a government that has a deficit of $200, $300, $400 million versus having a balanced budget? What could make the difference between us having an unemployment rate at being celebrated at 8% because it's lower than anything in the last 15 years versus an unemployment rate that was the lowest it's ever been in the history of the Bahamas that could be under 6, 4, 5%? What could make the difference? Someone say God? Yes, God could make that difference, but that's not what we're talking about. Because even if God is making that difference, this thing will be what God uses to help make that difference. So that, no, it's not God. It's a mystery, isn't it? What is that thing? And it's sitting out there all the time, not sometimes in the open, sometimes hidden. Sitting out there waiting to make a difference in your life, waiting to make a difference in my life. This text, it will muddle. Waiting to make a difference. It is the thing. See, I don't know. Yeah, it is the thing. It's out there waiting for you, waiting for me. And it can make a massive difference between your making 1% return on your money, 0.4% return on your money, and 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 15, 20, 25%. Turn in your money. Somebody say opportunity. No, opportunity is not it. Opportunity is dependent on this thing, but opportunity is not it. This thing makes a difference. Massive, massive difference. This thing is the difference between you're dying from a disease and you're being cured from a disease. That's how powerful this thing is. This thing can make the difference between you're having sound sleep at night and you're having restless sleep at night or no sleep at night. This thing will make the difference, huge difference. This says choice. Choice can be a part of that, but no choice is dependent on this thing. So that's, choice is not it, but yes, choice matters. Say health? No, health is not it. Health is dependent on this thing, but health is not it. What is it? that could make such a massive difference. You're listening to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. We're going to take a break. When we come back, I'll tell you what it is. We'll be back after this break.
I'm not afraid to take a stand, take a stand. Everybody, everybody, come take my hand, come take my hand. We'll walk this road together through the storm, whatever weather.
I mashed the car. The lady run into me mashed the car.
I hope she had insurance.
If she had insurance, she hop out, pull out her phone, pull up the Royal Star Assurance app, and bang, she was on a video call with an RSA rep, sending pictures of her damage, my damage, filing a claim on the spot.
For real? Our insurance have that kind of app?
You gotta go to RSA for that.
Download the RSA app today, or visit rsabahamas.com to submit your claim online. Live chat available weekdays 9 to 5.
Love the show? Want to give your support? Become a sponsor today. Call 302-2300 for our rates and packages. That's 302-2300. Become a sponsor on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
Secure your financial future with RF Bank and Trust. Explore the RF Secured Balance Fund, designed for long-term financial security. This the growth potential and a steady income source. Plan for the long term with a recommended minimum investment of 5 years. With over two decades of experience, RF Bank and Trust is your expert in preserving and growing wealth. We're your local private bank, connecting you with the best local and international investment opportunities. Don't miss the chance to secure your financial future with RF Bank and Trust.
I'm not afraid. I'm not afraid to take a stand. Take a stand.
Welcome back. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. We're so glad you could join us here today on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM on this Tuesday afternoon. I trust and hope that you are doing well. We got a caller on the line. Go ahead, caller. We're listening to you.
Yes, good afternoon, Mr. Laing, and Happy New Year
to
you.
Go ahead, caller.
Hello? Hello?
Hi.
Yes, yes, I was saying good afternoon and Happy New Year. Mr. Laing, I think that the difference, the thing that is going to make the difference, in my opinion, is faith and discipline. You know, I think if you have the faith to believe and the discipline to do and the determination, then, you know, you can handle anything.
Okay, thank you. I appreciate that. That's things depend on this thing, quite frankly. So,
okay.
But I understand what you're saying. This thing is like, you know, when you take flour and you take baking powder and you take sugar and you take salt and you them together as your dry ingredients. Now, maybe a part of your dry ingredients may be some coconut or some other flavoring, right? And then you take your wet ingredients, you take some milk and you take some eggs and you take some vanilla extract and you combine them with some butter and then you put all that together and you come up with this nice, delicious cake. I'm talking about delicious cake that melts in your mouth if you take it with some hot chocolate or something like that. This thing does that when you get it in your system. This text says resources. Actually,
the only thing that I can think about and it coming out good is that person must have the experience in order to do that. Because you just can't take it and take the flour and just throw it up. So you have that experience in that particular thing.
Experience depends on this thing. So thanks. Yeah, but experience depends on this thing.
Okay. Okay.
All right.
Then I'll sit back and listen.
Appreciate it. All right. This text says, good afternoon, Mr. Laing. Is it your mindset? No, somebody said that earlier. Your mindset depends on this thing. This text says, Happy New Year. I believe the one thing that you speak about is ourselves. That is you and I. We have to be and make the changes we wish to see in our lives. No, that's true what you say, but that's not the answer. This person says education. Education. Now, you are right. But this is the word I'm looking for. Information, is it? Information makes the difference between health and sickness. Information makes the difference between wellness, mental, and unwellness. Mental information makes the difference between how we manage our relationships. Information makes the difference between whether we'll have some money or don't have some money. Information is that raw ingredient that will make the difference between how the government manages its affairs and how it doesn't manage its affairs. Information, that's key. And so that's education, but education is a little broader more. Information, folks. That's the power. That's the thing that we need more than anything else that will make the difference. Because you can't get education without information. You can't have faith without information, because the Bible says faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Well, what is the word of God? Information. Right? So you don't get discipline unless you know what to be disciplined about. So information requirement. Information is a resource. It is that resource. Information. You say, I think I won the prize. No, education is broader and bigger than information. Information is basic thing. Information is you take, like your mom's giving you an example of the cake, right? So I could put all those ingredients together. I could put them on a table. And they are capable of making all sorts of things. They can use those same ingredients to make pancakes, waffles, crepe, pudding. I can use those same ingredients to make pound cake. I can use them to make all kinds of different things. But what I make depends on the information I have about what the ingredient quantities and how those ingredients have to be prepared and then mixed. That is information. See, those individual items you could regard as data. They are facts. But how to use them is information. And so somebody says, yeah, and I'm happy they did, says, must do something with the information. No, but see, nothing that is required before a thing is more important than the thing, right? So if you need something to get something, the thing you need, you need to get, can't be more important than the thing you need to get the thing. Okay, so you can't say to me, you have to use the information first. Because if you don't have the information, using the information doesn't even arise. Because you can't use what you don't have. Okay, that's like saying to me, oh, you have to put the ingredients together first to get the cake. Well, if you don't have the ingredients, can you get a cake? No. So let's not jump ahead. This is not rocket science. This is very basic stuff. And what I'm trying to get to you is that you and I need to be settled on the fact that we need information. Don't jump ahead of yourself. That's not a test for your genius or mine. Understand that what is required is information. What you do with it, how you experience it, all of that happens after you get it. But if you don't have it, you're done. It don't even arise. Right? You can't tell a child, well, you have to use the math after the fact. If the child doesn't get the math, there's nothing to use. We have to have the information. Information is critical. Says, good afternoon, Mr. Laing. What would make a difference if we show more love, as love covers a multitude of sin, helps someone along the way, and being able to accept when someone brings to your attention when you're wrong, simply look out for others, share your knowledge. I can go on and on, Mr. Laing. I would end by saying that we ourselves, when we do something wrong, we should know when to say we are sorry. Now, here's the thing. You just gave me a great number of very truthful things, but that's all information. That's the truth, right? Love, even love, requires you to have information about how to love, how to be patient, how to be kind, how to be gracious, right? So again, we need to be about the business of getting information. This says, Happy New Year, Mr. Laing. Is it money? No, it's not money. Even though money is useful, but money is also itself information, right? It's information. It's knowing that this thing stores value. This thing is a medium of exchange for me. This thing can be a measure of value and all that kind of stuff. So it's information, people. It's information. How do I eat better? I need information about how to eat, get my physical body in better shape. I need to have information. I can't just run in the gym and start doing this and start doing that because I could mess myself up. I need information. How do I relieve the stress in my life? I have to have information about what can help with proper stress management. How do I relate to other people in ways that are useful, helpful, and productive? I have to have an understanding of some things. How does the government manage its financial affairs better? It has to know some things about doing that better in the first instance. Now, it may know those things and don't do it. That's possible, but you have to at least know in the first instance what to do. And so it's information. It's information we need. We need information. Why are we suffering in so many ways? Even if you look at the scripture that says, the Bible says that my people perish for lack of vision. And that vision is really disciplined purpose. But what's disciplined purpose? Information about what I ought to be doing with myself. Right? And so again, it is being able to have the information that can point me in the right direction, give me the appropriate guidance, help me understand the purpose of things, and cause me to be able to do what I have to do. Okay, so listen, man, I don't know, but I can only tell you. I can only tell you, but I can tell you all this much. I am an information hog. That's the truth. When you see something, it strikes me that I don't know and understand, and that I think is necessary for me to understand, I'm going to get the information. When I have made mistakes in my life, big mistakes in my life, many times, not all the time, sometimes it's just outright rebellion, just outright doing the wrong thing, but sometimes it's because I didn't understand. I didn't have enough information. You know, Jesus said something on the cross for the religious people, right? I have to say it like that because some people listen to the show. They go, oh, you always be listening to the white man, Jesus, and all like that. Anyway, Jesus apparently said on the cross, he said, Father, forgive them. They know not what they do. Jesus is on the cross saying, these people who are killing me. Listen, we get mad with them for killing Jesus. That's what we do. I've heard people, Christian, the Jews kill Jesus, or the Romans kill Jesus. Jesus said, Father, forgive them. They know not what they do. In other words, Jesus said, these people here are ignorant about what they're doing. You think they didn't know they was killing Jesus? They knew they was killing Jesus. They just didn't have the information about what and who they were really killing, right? Really killing. This text says, information equals raw disciplined data. Knowledge equals proper comprehension, understanding of information, wisdom, proper execution of knowledge, vision, ability to see the future in the present. Yes, that's all of that is true. All of that is true. In the context in which the Bible used vision, it was really meaning cast off restraint. That's really what it meant. It meant to cast off restraint. That's a literal definition of it. Vision. So in other words, like people perish for a lack of casting off restraint. Really meaning for lack of discipline. And discipline is always tied to purpose. You are disciplined when you are in pursuit of purpose. You are indisciplined when you veer off from purpose. And that's the reality, right? But information, you need, see, for instance, this definition here of information equals raw data and knowledge is used in information. Think about it. You can't execute the wisdom without the knowledge. And you can't get the knowledge without the information. So what is first? And what is first? Is primary, and what is first is principal. All right, ladies and gentlemen, you're listening to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. We'll be back after this news break.
I'm not afraid to take a stand.
Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM, Nassau, Bahamas.
Loss of family members is very isolating, and people who have experienced loss appreciate when others have shared their grief. If you can't be there in person, go to the Nassau Guardian's website online at thenassauguardian.com and visit our obituary link. The Nassau Guardian's interactive obituary link allows you to read the funeral announcement, express condolences, or place photos on the online guestbook for one full year. Losing a loved one is painful. But that pain isn't the worst thing to happen. Friends, loved ones, colleagues, and neighbors who ignore the loss compound the pain. Should the bereaved family wish to place the obituary and photos on our obituary site, just contact the Guardian's Funeral Industry Partners or the Nassau Guardian. Remember, there isn't one magic right thing to say to someone experiencing loss that will make the loss less painful or easier to bear. The Nassau Guardian's obituary link, available online, at thenassauguardian.com.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. I'm so glad you could join us here today on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Afternoon. I trust and hope that you are doing well. If you want to give us a call, the numbers are 323-6232 or 325-4316 or 325-4259. You can call us from the Family Islands on 242-300-5720. You can text us on 422-4796, or you can WhatsApp me on 439-3043. This text says, thank you, information it is. There you go. So we're talking about the importance of information. You know what is incredible about information? Listen to this now. Information isn't trying to hide itself. Information is not evading you or trying to sneak itself so you can't see it. That information isn't interested in that. Information isn't prejudice. Information don't care if you're black or white, don't care what your nationality is, doesn't care what it is. Information doesn't care. Information is sitting out there, the most generous soul on planet Earth, willing to give itself up for every single person. The challenge is that information does require discovery. Generally speaking, it does require discovery. It does require that we do some work. Now, some people will come by information just by sheer experience and accident of experience. You know what I mean? You go and put your hand in that thing and the thing was hot. You got information now. That thing is hot and you know it. Now, somebody could have said to you before, be careful, that's hot. And that would have given you information that didn't have to be as expensive as the experience you had. But information isn't trying to hide from us. Information's there. It's out there. It is simply requiring a process of discovery on our part. Now, here is the thing about information, though. That process of discovery oftentimes requires mental extras people are unwilling to do. Unwilling. Somebody says, yes, research. Yes, getting information can require research, but not in the typical sense of research. Not all information requires research. Some information just requires you sitting your backside down and listening to people who have the information. That's all. That's the reality. You sit in school and teachers teaching. That's not research. That's listening with the aim to understand. See? And so some of it is just learning, as in being in an environment to learn. Some of it requires experience, meaning being in a circumstance to understand, like driving, right? And some of it does require research, like some business plans that require market research, or some academic debate that requires scholarly research. But what is key is, let me tell you what's key. It's key, see? This is key. You have to be an information hog first. What do I mean by that? I mean, you have to have a real appetite for information. You cannot sit around life hating on people who got information, talking about who's elite because they got all this knowledge, and talking about who's arrogant because they think they know everything. See, all that is irrelevant. What is important is, if you have a hunger for information, do you really want to know stuff? Do you really? And what is the stuff you want to know? In fact, this is how you start. What is the stuff I need to know? What is it that I don't know that I now need to know? Can we talk about some of the stuff we need to know? How about how to take care of your health? Somebody says, yeah, information sponge. No, I don't want you to be an information sponge, because there's some stuff like that counts as information that if you're a sponge, it means you're just passively absorbing. You don't want to do that. You want to be an active participant in your knowledge process, right? And so you want to be more than a sponge. You really want to be, right? And that hunger could mean, though, just because you're hungry don't mean you can put rocks in your mouth, right? So not quite a sponge, you know. I want you to be have a real hunger for it, the information. Some people are soaking up all kind of crap out there. And some of it is information, but some of it is unhelpful information. Some of it, well, let's put it like this. some of it is problematic, right? And so you can say, you know, that's information, but I don't need that. But the thing is, you have to ask yourself, what is the information I need? What is it that I do not know that I need to know? And so you could start out with the most basic and fundamental thing. You ask yourself, you ask this question. Doing what I'm doing now, how healthy have I become? And how healthy am I likely to be as I age and continue to age? So if then you discover, you know what? Well, like markers, you know, I got high blood pressure, I got high cholesterol, I'm overweight, you know, and I look at those kinds of things, then I know something is amiss. And so I said, what is the information that I need that can help me improve those markers? So that's need. That's for my existential health. Right? And so you ask yourself that question. Like, I keep making the same errors with money. I keep making the same errors with relationship. I keep making the same errors with my job performance and so forth. What is it that I don't know that I need to know so that I can not make these same errors? That's a need to know. It's information I need to be hungry for. You see what I mean? And so once you decide what you need, you don't even negotiate with trying to get that information because you don't negotiate with what you need. Right? And so you chase after what you need. I tell people, listen, the other day we were talking and I was saying to him, son, this is how your daddy approaches life. I ask myself first, what do I need? And he said, well, you know, there's some, you know, I mean, like everybody knows that basic need is food, et cetera, et cetera. I said, well, that's true. But we know we need food, but we don't know what kind of food we need all the time. Some of us do not know. That's why we get food, but the kind of food we're getting is actually killing us. And so we're actually working against our own need, right? So I said, but their needs are more than that, right? Because you could think about the fact that, you know, I need to be in an environment that enriches my knowledge because that satisfies me, right? And so you look at those kinds of things. So that causes you to ask the question, how much do I know about myself? And that takes you into a process of self-discovery. So you want to talk about what you need. Then you ask yourself, what do I want? So I know what I need. I don't negotiate with those. What is it that I want? What do I want? And this is your want. You don't have to be shy about that. I want more money, you say. I want a better car, you say. I want a better relationship, you say. That's what you want. Now you have to ask yourself, what is the information that I require that can help me with those things? Right? Now, let me tell you the gap between what I need and what I want that I also feel. Okay? This is the truth. I ask, what do I believe? I asked that. I didn't say you asked that. I said, I ask that question. After I ask, what do I need? I then ask, what is it that I believe God wants of me? And then I ask, what do I want? That's the order of things for me, right? And so that too requires me to get some information, right? To help myself. This text says, absolutely, Mr. Lang, just listening. I often say to persons in my circle that I do my best to make time for your show. It's my university class time. I appreciate that. This text is designed to show or have love. It goes hand in hand with kindness and caring for others. Okay. So, your, if you want to order your quest for information, so this is a frame that I use. It's a frame I use. I don't say you have to use it, but it's a frame I need. And it's important to know what you need versus what you want. You to be able to distinguish between those two. What do I need? Because once it's a need, there's no negotiating with it. It becomes a non-negotiable in your life. I need this. I need this thing. Okay? And so you see your need and you try to get the information that helps you in that pursuit. What is it that I want? If you don't put in the middle there, what is it that I believe God wants of me? That's up to you. What is it that I want? That's my ambition. That's my aspirations. That's my dreams. That's my goals. Right? And then you ask, what can I contribute? That's the other thing. So once I figure out what can I contribute, then I can start to get information to help me. Okay? And so we need information that will help us do these things in 2024. And so I say to you, let information be your aim. Sit down and listen. Sit down and read and search. Before you go and do a project, spend time thinking, writing, confirming, you know, that's important. The carpenters say, measure twice, cut once. The academicians say, think for 2 hours, write for one. Right? Why? What are they saying? They're saying, listen, do the work you need to do before you try to execute. Do the work you need to do before you try to execute. See, executing feels good to us because we feel like we're doing something. So as long as I'm busy, I feel like I'm doing something. And the truth is, you are. But are you effective? Meaning, are you doing the right things? We could be ineffective if we have bad information. Let me tell you all something about it. Let me tell you all something. God, my witness. Man, I was putting up this shelf for my daughter when she was in university. And to be honest with you, I wasn't paying as much attention to the information on the instructions as I should have. And I got to the very last half later, almost 2 hours later. And I'm just looking at this thing and thinking, man, something's off here. Why do I have this one piece of thing in my hand? One piece of thing in my hand. Why do I have this one piece? This something's wrong. This can't be right. I mean, the thing is up, but it little shaky. And this don't seem right. And I went back and read the instructions. Listen to me, people. My second step was incorrect. And everything I did after that, even though it worked, the thing was not right, and I had to take the whole thing back down to the second step, 2 more hours to go. Why? I didn't have the right information. I was busy. Boy, listen, couldn't tell me I wasn't making myself proud, my daughter proud, waking and she's smiling as she's looking and seeing this thing, blah, 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 blah. So being busy can feel good. Are you effective? Right? Are you effective is the question. Information will help you and I achieve the effectiveness that we want and we need to get things done properly and be able to get us the results that we desire. And that's what we want. That's what we want. We want good results for ourselves, good results in our health, good results in our wellness, good results in our relationships, good results in our finances, good results in our community contributions. We want good results. Some of us, we have awful attitudes. Seriously, we have stink attitudes. We treat people poorly. We are fake. We are pretentious. We fake. We are selfish, we are egotistical. Some of us, we are self-centered. We don't understand sometimes how badly we come across because we are so self-centered. And guess what? People look at us and go, and people hate us, hate on us. I mean, they are angry with us, right? And they talk badly about us and they huff and puff about us, right? And the truth is, sometimes we are just like the Romans and the Jews who were there shouting, crucify him. And Jesus looking back at us and saying, Father, forgive them. They don't know what they do. Because sometimes the people who you are calling arrogant, you're calling nasty, you're calling this, they haven't a clue really what they're doing. They never had the information that, listen, you know, you can't interact with people that way. You shouldn't do this that way. This is a better way. They have never. You just think they have. In fact, you're so busy in your own stinking nasty attitude, looking at their stinking nasty attitude, you don't even see your stinking nasty attitude. So the two of us got stinking nasty attitudes, stinking up the whole world, but you, in your arrogance, think that you're the one who is so good. Somehow Jesus and God blessed you with the most wonderful, nicest personality on planet Earth. Why? Why are you like that? Why am I like that? You even don't know. Don't have the information. Don't have the information on how to look at your own self and understand when you are. You don't. And that's why we get the information. That's why we got it. We got to learn. We could try. So you have to take yourself in parts, right? You got to, like, what parts of me am I trying to make better? What parts of me am I trying to do better? Do I want to speak better? Do I want to listen better? Do I want to share better? Do I want to care better? Do I want to drink less? Do I want to smoke less? Do I want to sex less? Or some people might say. Do I want to pray more, better? Do I want to de-stress? And get some information. Do I want to judge the performance of my government better? Well, how about I get some information on how to judge the performance of my government? Before we end the day, I'm going to talk a little bit about the Freedom of Information Act and the news that the commission, the Freedom of Information Commissioner has in the newspaper today. Information is key. Yeah, let me tell you something. Y'all don't tell nobody I tell you all this. Don't tell nobody I tell you this. Whatever we say or talk about on Z Live stays on Z Live. So don't tell nobody I tell you all this. So, you see the government of the Bahamas? Where is the government independent? Ingram, Christie, or Davis, or whoever else comes after that. See them? You want to compel them to do better and more? You want to know how to do it? Listen to me. Listen to Zhivargo, Sean, Laing, you've been there. Listen to me. Be dogged, dogged, dogged. You know that word? D-O-G-G-E-D. Dogged, dogged. You know when a dog wants something and really wants something, you know a dog is relentless in trying to get that thing. They got that thing, that jaw, they got that door locked on that thing. Dogged in requesting, demanding, and pursuing information from the government. Did you hear me? Be dogged in requesting and pursuing information from the government. Now, I know people say, oh, but the information, Freedom of Information Act ain't available yet, ain't available. Let me tell you something. If you keep asking a question and don't get an answer, you've gotten your answer. Just keep asking the question. You keep asking somebody. Do you like me? Do you like me? Do you like me? Do you like me? Do you and they don't give you an answer. You don't think you have your answer? What you do with the money? 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 What you do? How much money did you get? How much money did you pay? How much money did you pay? How much money? And they don't answer. You don't think you got an answer? Be dogged about getting information. That's how you get information. And take it from me. The people who hear you asking the question over and repeatedly and repeatedly and repeatedly and repeatedly, they understand what is going on and they will be affected by that behavior. You know what gets them off the hook? You ask a question once or twice and go on about your next business because you're chasing the next boon. And you're wondering why they don't care? Why would they care? Why should they care? Information is the most powerful thing at your disposal. Not merely the possession of it, but the request for it. Because it shines the light in the darkness. And anybody who's doing good in the darkness, I have no problem with the light shining. But when you're not doing good in the darkness, when you have the light shown, it's going to be a problem. Well, the speaker says she's tired of this hedging thing. Keep asking the question. And when the people who you are asking the question, I'll tell you they are tired of asking the question, what you did? You got your answer. You don't have to listen to me. I'm just saying, keep asking the question. How much did y'all pay them? You know, I asked you this yesterday, but you didn't give me an answer. How much did y'all pay them? You know, I have been asking you this for the last 2 weeks, but you hadn't answered me yet. How much did y'all pay them? And then, when election time come and they say, could I have your vote? Go answer. You can say, well, how come you're not asking me? Because I asked you a question 50 times and you ain't had the courtesy to answer me. You're listening to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. We'll be back after this break.
Struggling to repay your loan? Let us help you get back on track with payment or financial situation and improve your credit score and credit report with the Bahamas Credit Bureau. Inquire about our restructured loans today. Call us at 356-7764.
Secure your financial future with RF Bank and Trust. Explore the RF Secured Balance Fund, designed for long-term financial security. This diversified fund offers both growth potential and a steady income source. Plan for the long term with a recommended minimum investment of 5 years. With over 2 decades of experience, RF Bank and Trust is your expert in preserving and growing wealth. We're your local private bank, connecting you with the best local and international investment opportunities. Don't miss the chance to secure your financial future with RF Bank and Trust.
Spice up your taste buds this season with the new Jalapeno Rodeo Burger at Burger King Nassau. Each bite of the Jalapeno Rodeo features a classic flame-grilled beef patty, pepper jack cheese, crunchy fried onions, and a spicy jalapeno kick, topped with barbecue and chipotle sauce, served on a soft potato bun. The Jalapeno Rodeo Burger is even tastier in a combo with our new half-seas, half onion rings, and half french fries with a drink, or cool it down with the new and delicious creamy floats collection at Burger King Nassau, where taste is king.
This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM, Nassau, Bahamas.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. So glad that you could join us here today on Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM, on this beautiful Tuesday afternoon. If you want to give us a call, the numbers are 323-6232, 325-4316, or 325-4259. You can text us on 4224796. That's 4224796. Or you can WhatsApp me 439-3043. It's 439-3043. So, this year, let information be a principal aim for you. Try to get that information you require to achieve the results you desire. It's my recommendation to you. So, in the Nassau Guardian today, article discussing the Freedom of Information Act. In that article written by Chandia Dames, the Freedom of Information Commissioner, Keith Thompson, is saying that they are waiting for some technology and some regulations in order to facilitate a pilot project in respect of freedom of information. He said that the ball is in the park of the Attorney General's office and the Prime Minister's office. He says, we've done all of the necessary training of information officers and managers. We've collaborated with the consultant who guided us through the whole process. Now we're at the stage where we are waiting for the technology and the regulations and the fee schedule to be passed in both houses of parliament, he says. So let me give you a little bit of background to refresh your memory. The first Freedom of Information Act was passed in 2012. That was under the Ingram administration. I was in government at the time. Granted, in my view, that for a long time, anyways. So it was passed in 2012. Then, in 2015 or thereabouts, the government decided that there were some delinquencies in the Freedom of Information Act. And people were complaining about some exemptions and all that kind of stuff. And so there was an amendment done to the Freedom of Information Act, and it was passed in 2017 again. It was, the first one was repealed. The 2012 was repealed 5 years later. And then a new act was passed in the parliament in 2017. That was under the Minister's administration. Let me see. No, that was under the Christie administration, right? And then, no. That was under the, that's under the Christie administration, yeah. And then that administration said they would target May 2020 to actually bring the legislation into force, into effect, right? Fully implemented. Okay, that's with all the whistle, all the thingamajig and all that kind of stuff, all the stuff, the whistleblower protection, all that kind of stuff. And it was in fact brought into effect in April 2017. Then the Minister administration, right? And so now, 2024, Freedom of Information Commissioner is saying, we're waiting on technology and we're waiting on some regulations. This is, folks, now 12 years. 12 years. 12 years. The government of the Bahamas has been playing around with Freedom of Information Act. 12 years. 12 years across all the administrations from 2012 to now, 12 years, no Freedom of Information Act. Remember I said information is key? Think about what the Freedom of Information Act does. The Freedom of Information Act holds the government accountable for its conduct. It ensures that the government is made to reveal what it has done in some areas. It ensures that the government is transparent, meaning that one can see what the government has done. That's what the Freedom of Information assists with. Now, it's not the only thing that does that, because there are some laws that require the government to publish, right? So like the Disclosure Act is an information disclosure, right? There are reports that the government is expected, fiscal responsibility reports, education reports, etc. These are things that are required. The commissioner's strategic plan, these are required by law, right? And so the Freedom of Information Act is not the only way and only thing that allows the government to say what it's doing. But it does permit you to be targeted and selective in what it is you're seeking to know from the government. 12 years later, the commissioner is saying, I'm waiting on the government to give me some technology, and I'm waiting on the government to give me some additional regulations and some fees and so forth and so forth. 12 years later. Why do you think this is? Let me ask you a question. Let me ask you this question. If the Freedom of Information Act was an act that the government believed would make it exceptionally popular, any government, Ingram, Christie, Minnis, Davis, any government believe they would make it exceptionally crisp. Do you think it would take 12 years for that act to be passed and come into full effect? Anybody, answer me. If the government thought, any government, Christie, Ingram, all of them thought, boy, when we pass this, people are gonna love us. How long do you think it would take for that act to be passed? They see, unfortunately, they can't ask for this Freedom of Information Act forever, but this will never be produced. So they can ask for it forever, but this will never be produced. It can be produced. It can come into full effect. It will. Would have been done long ago. You're absolutely right. Absolutely right. So let me be clear now. Don't you all run around here talking about, oh, the Davis administration. Davis administration, nothing. The administrations of the Bahamas, the Commonwealth of the Bahamas, have not been comfortable, not been eager or enthusiastic about implementing the Freedom of Information Act. Have not. Not for the reason sometimes you think that they go, okay, you can find out corruption. You may find out corruption, but you may find out some information with some patronage that some people don't want you to know. You may find out some information about some levels of spending and some ways of spending happy about. So none of those have to be corruption. They just have to be things you say, but gee, are you all serious? Are you all really serious? It's like finding out at NASA you pay like $1,500 for a nut. None of the things you use a screw on. This text says, as usual, I can't wait until AI robots take over. So when companies try swing the robots out their vacation pay to see the backlash from the employees, some employers ain't sick. Say successive governments say the country too small. Smallness has something to do with it for sure. Smallness has something to do with it for sure. But the slowness of it really is about the fact that there's not a lot of enthusiasm to do it. Prime Minister Davis promised that he was going to cut VAT when he came to office. He did that in months. In months he cut VAT. He promised to increase minimum wage for public servants. Some areas did that in months. Freedom of Information Act. Ingram said he was going to pass the Freedom of Information Act. Ingram, you know when he passed it? 2012. 5 years on later when he was getting ready, when he get with the time to get ready to go to the election and get kicked out of office. Minister said he was going to do it. When did he do it? 2017. But when did it come into force? Never. He said he was going to bring it into force in 2020. Never. Two, almost 3 years into the Davis administration. You're listening to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. We're going to take our final break. We'll be back after this break.
I'm not afraid to take a stand, take a stand. Everybody, come take my hand, come take my hand. We'll walk this road together through the storm, whatever weather.
Your financial future with RF Bank and Trust. Explore the RF Secured Balance Fund, designed for long-term financial security. This diversified fund offers both growth potential and a steady income source. Plan for the long term with a recommended minimum investment of 5 years. With over two decades of experience, RF Bank and Trust is your expert in preserving and growing wealth. We're your local private bank, connecting you with the best local and international investment opportunities. Don't miss the chance to secure your financial future with RF Bank and Trust.
Love the show? Want to give your support? Become a sponsor today. Call 302-230-PACKAGES. That's 302-230-0. Become a sponsor on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
I mashed the car. The lady who ran into me mashed the car.
I hope she had insurance.
If she had insurance, she hop out, pull out her phone, pull up the Royal Star Assurance app, and bang, she was on a video call with an RSA rep, sending pictures of her damage, my damage, filing a claim on the spot.
For real? Our insurance have that kind of app?
You gotta go to RSA for that.
Download the RSA app today or visit rsabahamas.com to submit your claim online. Live chat available weekdays 9 to 5.
Spice up your taste buds this season with the new Jalapeno Rodeo Burger at Burger King Nassau. Each bite of the Jalapeno Rodeo features a classic flame-grilled beef patty, pepper jack cheese, crunchy fried onions, and a spicy jalapeno kick, topped with barbecue and chipotle sauce, served on a soft potato bun. The Jalapeno Rodeo Burger is even tastier in a combo with our new half-seas, half onion rings, and half french fries with a drink, or cool it down with a new and delicious creamy floats collection at Burger King Nassau, where taste is king.
Struggling to repay your loan? Let us help you get back on track with payment terms that suits your financial situation and improve your credit score and credit report with the Bahamas Credit Bureau. Inquire about our restructured loans today. Call us at 356-7764.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. So glad you could join us here today on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM on this beautiful Tuesday afternoon. Let me ask you a question. What does public relations do? What does public relations do? Like, when you get a public relations firm, what does that do? What does Bahamas Information Services do? Doesn't a public relations firm and Bahamas Information Service get information about the government out to the public? So there is a sense in which the government wants information out, right? On itself. So the government wants you to know the prime minister made a speech here, and you, the government wants you to know that the government built this number of houses. The government wants you to know that the government created this number of jobs. The government wants you to know that the government reduced the VAT. And the government wants you to know a lot of things about itself. That's why it has Bahamas Information Services. That's why it controls ZNS. That's why it has public relations machinery. This is where any administration now, right? All administrations, not like Ingram never had a press secretary or anything like that, but like some of these other prime ministers and administrations, but he also used the media to try to get information out, right? Because whenever the thing is good and positive, the government won't get the information out. If it wants to warn you, be careful of something, it puts the information out. But if the government wants to get information out, why the Freedom of Information Act is taking so long? What? That's information. That could get people information. Think about that for a moment. But be the challenge. Think about this for a moment. So one administration, like one group in opposition, screaming, oh, they didn't not corrupt things. They hiding things from you, right? So in opposition say that. Then they become the government where they could get the information to show you people were doing. Wouldn't the Freedom of Information Act make it easier for you to get that information that they said these people were hiding from you when they were in office? But they get in office and the Freedom of Information Act don't move. Ingram get in office, don't pass it till late. Christie get in office, don't pass it. Don't bring it into force. Minutes get in office, don't bring it into force. Davis is in office, it's not in force yet. Why? It's information. Information is good. Think about this for a moment. If information isn't powerful, why are people not eager to get some of it out? If it's not so powerful, it's powerful. That's why. It's powerful. Someone say they're guilty of something. Something. And again, I'm saying it's not necessarily corruption. What happens is, let me tell you all, what stays in the bar and on what's said on Z Live stays on Z Live. So don't tell nobody, I tell you all this. There's corruption in government. There's corruption in government. And it's not all, and government isn't only about politicians. Some corruption in government just have to do with people who work in government. And some of the corruption isn't like that kind of egregious corruption that you might think. It's so awful and terrible. It's just like what you do when you tip somebody to get something done for you. That's corruption, you know. You didn't realize that. Yeah, you're corrupting the process because the process isn't supposed to work like that. So you just corrupted it. Yeah, you're eye on the politician, but you are a corrupter. Who does that? I'm not saying that. Right? Nepotism, yeah, it's good corruption, all that kind of stuff, right? So what happens is, what would really biggest embarrassment in government, biggest embarrassment to governments, to government administration, the biggest embarrassment, the biggest, most prevailing embarrassment, let me keep the fraternity secret. The thing that would probably embarrass administrations most is patronage. patronage, the extent to which the government uses its machinery to benefit its supporters. It's extensive across administrations. Extensive. Patronage, that's really the thing that would probably embarrass administrations the most. It's not evil or wicked or corrupt, but it's a system that permeates the system that maintains the sentiment that to the victor goes the spoils. The notion that these people will go out there and work hard to get you elected and then need to be rewarded for their service, and so you do things for them in the way of employment, in the way of contracts, in the way of projects and like facilitation of things and so forth and so forth. Those would probably be the most embarrassing things. Now if some levels of the corruptions get discovered, that I don't know, I can't tell you what they could be. Maybe that's something different, but I think the most pervasive, sustained thing is the level of patronage that takes place in the Commonwealth of the Bahamas. It's extensive. And it's extensive not only because politicians do it, but because what they expect it. And they use the argument, when them other people was in power, I couldn't get this and I couldn't get that. All they doing is taking care of F&Ms. All they doing is taking care of PLPs. The same people who did this to us when we were in office. You hear that with great frequency. Great frequency. And you hear it from up and down the chain. Up and down the chain. Y'all ain't taking care. I tell y'all, I heard a senior government person tell me, oh, that thing ain't happening for you because they say they tired of you, me only doing things for people who are against me. That's what I was told that. Right? So this patronage is like, listen, if you get it out of government, like, I don't know what government would look like. I don't know what political parties would look like. Because, like, it is not unusual. If you are F&M or PLP who's been active in either parties, tell me if you haven't heard this. Soon after the government is elected, not very long after, a couple of months after, tell me if you hadn't heard, yeah, the government changed, but ain't nothing changed. Same set of people still in power. So like the expectation is when you get in power, you need to get rid of them people, APLPs, AFNMs. I lie. Right? Information is power. Information can alter things. Information can impact outcomes. Information can move the world. It has moved the world. If used correctly, it can significantly and positively move your world, our world, and our country. Anyway, yeah, see somebody say, yep, say y'all win, but we still in power. Mm-hmm. You heard it. You hear it. They goosing you. Goosing you and then causing them politicians to feel the pressure. Trying to get rid of some people or trying to get rid of some people so you can put some people in place. Ah, people. You've been listening to Z Live. I'm Zhivargo Laing, your host. So glad that I could talk to you today on this first show for 2024. God bless you. He spares life. We'll talk to you again tomorrow.
Looks like we made it. Look how far we've come, my baby. We might have took the long way. We knew we'd get there someday. They said, I bet they'll never make it. But just look at us holding on. We're still together, still going strong. Still, you're still the one.